वेलकम ऑल इन लेक्चर नंबर 3 लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल्स. सो टिल नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड टू लेक्चर्स. सो इन लेक्चर नंबर 1 वी डिस्कस्ड व्हाट इज मीन बाय लीनियर इक्वेशन, द बेसिक डेफिनेशन, व्हाट इज मीन बाय साइमल्टेनियस इक्वेशन एंड हाउ वी कैन आइडेंटिफाई द गिवन पर्टिकुलर इक्वेशन, वेदर इट इज लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल्स और नॉट. And after that, in lecture number 2, we solved some examples like to how to solve the two equations and how to find out the solution of these two equations by two methods. One is elimination method and other is substitution method. And in this lecture, we'll discuss these numericals by another method, that is graphical method, means how we can find out the solution of these linear equations by graphical method, as well as after that we'll discuss determinant. So let's start the lecture number 3. So this was the homework question which was given in lecture number 2. So we'll solve this question first and after that we'll move to the next topic. So the question is, solve the following simultaneous equation by graphical method. Complete the following tables to get ordered pairs. So in lecture number 2, we discussed what is meant by ordered pairs. Ordered pairs are the points. So these points satisfy the given equation. Okay. So the given equation is x minus y equal to 1. So I'm giving number 1 to this equation. X minus y is equal to 1. And I told you earlier like how to find out the ordered points. Just put the value of x equal to 0, find out the value of y, and in another case put the value of y equal to 0, find out the value of x, or you can take certain values like x equal to minus 2, minus 1, 0, comma 1. These are the basic value. You can take any value, okay, and find out the value of y at the particular points. And after that you will get the pairs. So that pair is known as ordered pair. Okay, and these points will satisfy the given equation. So x minus y equal to 1, this is the given equation, and in the table already they have given the value of x. So value of x in the first column is 0, so we have to put the value of x in 0. So I am writing the given equation as it is first, x minus y equal to 1. So put x equal to 0, then let's see what is the value of y. Then when we put x equal to 0, then y becomes minus 1. Okay, it's a simple calculation, you can calculate. So the value of y is minus 1, so the coordinates will be 0 comma minus 1, x and y. Okay, so in the next column they have given the value of y, so we have to put, this is the first case, second case, put y equal to 0, then we have to find out the value of x. If you put y equal to 0 in the given equation, what is the value of x? X equal to 1. X minus 0 equal to 1, that is x equal to 1. So when we put y equal to 0, we get the value of x is 1. So the coordinates will be 1 comma 0. The next case, put the value of x equal to 3. Put x equal to 3 in the given equation. So 3 minus y equal to 1, so minus y equal to 1 minus 3, that is minus 2, so the value of y is 2. So the value of y is 2, the coordinates will be 3 comma 2, and they have given the value of y is minus 3. So put y equal to minus 3 in the given equation. See, x minus of minus 3, that is x plus 3 equal to 1. So the value of x is 1 minus 3, that is minus 2. So this is the value of x, that is minus 2. The coordinates will be minus 2 comma minus 3. So likewise, you have to fill other table also. See, we have calculated the values, we have calculated the ordered pairs, and you can plot this point in a graph and just draw a line passing through this point. So you will get the line x minus y is equal to 1. So next case, next equation is 5x minus 3y is equal to 1. So I am writing this equation as equation number 2, and they have given the value of x equal to 2. So we have to put value of x equal to 2 and find out the value of y. So see, 5x minus 3y equal to 1. This is the given equation. So we have to put value of x equal to 2. So 5 multiplied by 2 minus 3y equal to 1. So in your exam, you have to write step by step. Okay. Because marks are allocated for steps only. So 5 into 2, 10. 10 minus 3y equal to 1. So minus 3y, 1 minus 10. So minus 3y becomes minus 9. Okay. 1 minus 10 means minus 9. So minus minus will get cancelled and the value of y equal to 3. So the first case, when we put x equal to 2, we will get value of y equal to 3. The coordinate will be 2 comma 3. In the next case, they have given the value of y is equal to 8. So put y equal to 8 and find out the value of x. So 5x minus 3 into 8, that is 24, right? 3 into 8 minus 24 is equal to 1. So this minus 24, if we move to right hand side, it will become plus 24. So 1 plus 24, 25. So 5x equal to 25, then x equal to what? X equal to 5. The value of x is 5. The coordinates will be 5, 8. Right? Next case. They have given the value of y equal to minus 2. The same thing. Put y equal to minus 2 in the given equation. So 5x minus 3 into y equal to minus 2, it will become plus 6 is equal to 1. Okay, so 5x is equal to minus 5, then x equal to minus 1. So this is the value of x when we put y equal to minus 2. Minus 1, so coordinate will be minus 1 comma minus 2, right? Then we have to put the value of x equal to minus 4 in the given equation. So put x equal to minus 4. So just find out the value of y. Then 5 into minus 4, that is minus 20, minus 3y equal to 1. Okay, so minus 20 minus 3y is equal to 1. So this minus 20, if you move to right hand side, it will become plus 20. So 1 plus 20, that is 21. So minus 3y equal to 21. Then y becomes minus 7. Right, value of y is minus 7. So the coordinate will be minus 4 comma minus 7. So these are the ordered pairs. Just focus on the third row. Okay, this third row. So these are the ordered pair. Okay, and what you have to do now, just plot this point in a graph and draw a line passing through this point. So you will get two lines, and these two lines will intersect at one point. So that point will be the solution of the given equation. But as of now, in the question, they have not asked us to find out the solution of this equation. But you can find out the solution by just checking the intersecting point. So the point at which the two lines are intersecting, that point is the solution of the two equation. Anyway, you can find out the solution of this two equation by using elimination method also. Okay, so I'll show you how we can find out the solution of this two equation by using elimination method. Okay, see the equation 1, x minus y equal to 1. So this is the equation number 1. Okay, x minus y equal to 1, this is the equation number 1, and the second equation is 5x minus 3y is equal to 1. Okay, so 5x minus 3y equal to 1, this is the second number equation. This is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. Now we are solving this equation by elimination method. So just multiply equation number 1 by 3. Okay, so I'm multiplying equation number 1 by 3. So what will you get? 3x minus 3y equal to 3. 3x minus 3y equal to 3. So I am writing this equation number as 3, and then just subtract equation number 3 from equation number 2. So if you subtract, the sign will get interchange. 5x minus 3x, that is 2x. Minus 3y plus 3y will get cancelled. So 1 minus 3, it becomes minus 2. So the value of x is equal to minus 1. Okay, value of x is equal to minus 1, and if you put the value of x equal to minus 1 in above equation 1, 2 or 3, any one, So we will get the value of y. So whichever the equation is simple, just put the value of x in that. So I'm putting it into equation number 1. So x minus y equal to 1. This is the equation number 1. So I'm putting the value of x equal to minus 1 in equation number 1. Minus 1 minus y is equal to 1. So minus y is equal to 1 plus 1, that is 2. So the value of y is minus 2. Okay. So this is the solution of the given equation. Which is the solution? The value x minus 1 comma minus 2. So this is the solution of the given equation, and you can find out the solution by using graphical method also. Just check the intersecting point. So intersecting point is the your solution. Okay, so this was the homework question. So let's move to the further slides. This is the another question from practice set 1.2. So we'll solve this same as before. The two equations are given, x plus y equal to 3 and x minus y is equal to 4, and the some values in the table are given. Just we have to find out the remaining values. So equation is x plus y is equal to 3, right? This is equation number 1, and the value of x is given, x equal to 3 is given already. So we have to find out the value of y. But if you see in the table, the two coordinates are already given, 3 comma 0. So no need to calculate, just the x coordinate is 3 and y is 0. Just put the value directly. In the second column we have to calculate. In the third column, see, the two coordinates are already given, 0 comma 3. So x 0 and y is 3. Simple, no need of calculation. And the second column will calculate the value of x. The value of y is given, so put y equal to 5. Right, if you put y equal to 5, what we will get? So x plus 5 equal to 3. So x equal to 3 minus 5, that is minus 2. This is the value of x if you put y equal to 5. So minus 2, the coordinates will be minus 2 comma 5. Okay, now what is the next equation? The next equation is x minus y equal to 4. So this is the equation number 2, and we have to put the values in this equation. So first of all, they have given the value of y, so put y equal to 0 in the above equation. So x is equal to 4, this is the value of x. So 4 and 0, so coordinates will be 4 comma 0. Okay, in the next case they have given the value of x equal to minus 1, so put x equal to minus 1 in the given equation. So minus 1 minus y equal to 4. Minus 1, if you move to right hand side, it will become plus 1. So 4 plus 1, 5. But y equal to minus 5. Okay, it's a simple calculation. You can also calculate this. So the value is minus 1 and y is minus 5. The coordinates will be minus 1 comma minus 5. And the third column, they have already given the coordinates. So these equations, you can also find out the solution of this equation by using graphical method. What you have to do, just plot this point, focus on row number 3 as before. Focus on row number 3 and plot this point in graph, and draw a line passing through this point. And as well as for this equation also, make a plot this point in a graph and just draw a line which is passing through all these points. So you will get two lines which are intersecting at one point. So that point will be your solution. Anyway, you can find out the solution by using graphical method, sorry, by using elimination method also. So what is the elimination method? I will solve by elimination method and I will show you the solution of this equation. So first equation is x plus y equal to 3. This is equation number 1. X minus y equal to 4. This is the second number equation. So elimination method is just add these two equations. So 2x plus y minus y will get cancelled, equal to 7. Right, so x value equal to 7/2. This is the value of x, and we have to put value of x in any above equation. So I'm putting value of x in equation number 1. So what I will get? 7/2 plus y equal to 3. So y equal to 3 minus 7/2. Right, just a cross multiplication, simple calculation. 6 minus 7/2, that is minus 1 upon 2. This is the value of y. Okay, so this is the solution of these two equation. Anyway, you can find out the solution by using graphical method also. So next topic, and these are the two homework questions. You have to find out the solution and comment below what is the value of x, what is the value of y in the equation number 1 and equation number 2. Okay, so let's move to the next topic. So next topic is determinant. So what is mean by determinant? So determinant is nothing but it is represented by this form. Okay, the two in two vertical lines A, B and C, D. C, A, B, C, D are the elements. Okay, so this is the determinant A, B and C, D. See, the horizontal rows A, B and C, D are the rows, and A, C and B, D are the columns. Okay, so this is the general form of a determinant, any determinant of degree 2. So what is mean by degree? Okay, so degree of this determinant is 2. Why 2? Because there are 2 elements in each column and 2 elements in each row. Okay, so in each column if there are 2 elements and if it each row there are 2 elements, then that determinant is known as degree of 2. Okay, so what is the value of this determinant? Anyway, in exam they ask to find out the value of this determinant. So what is the value? How we can calculate the value of any determinant? See, I'm writing this A, B, C, D. So this is the determinant, and the determinant is always denoted by capital letter. Suppose A, B, anything but capital letter. Okay, now we have to find out the value of this determinant. So how we can calculate the value? Just take a cross multiplication, A into D, A into D minus B into C, B into C. Remember the direction, AD minus BC. Just take a cross multiplication and subtract. So this is the value of any determinant. Okay, for example, if you want to find out the value of this determinant, 2, 1, then 4 and 3. Okay, so now we have to find out the value of this determinant. This determinant is P. Okay, so how we can calculate the value? Just take a cross multiplication, 2 into 3, 2 into 3 minus 4 into 1, 4 into 1. So that's it. P equal to 6 minus 4. So what is the value of this determinant? Answer is 2. So in this way, we can calculate the value of any determinant of degree 2. There are determinants of degree 3 and 4 also, but it is not in your syllabus. So for the time being, just focus on the determinant of degree 2. Okay. Now let's solve some examples on the determinant, how we can calculate the value. See, we have to find out the value of A. So what is the value of A? Take a cross multiplication, 5 into 9 minus 3 into 7. Okay, just you have to take a cross multiplication and you will get the answer. So nothing much difficult in this. So see, 9 into 5, 45. And 3 into 7 minus 21. So what is the answer? 24 is the answer of this determinant A. Okay, now we have to find out the value of n. So n equal to, take a cross multiplication, minus 8 into 4 minus 8 into 4 minus 10 as it is, and minus 3 into 2. Okay, so 8 minus 8 into 4, that is minus 32. Minus minus, it will get plus, and 3 into 2, 6. So what is the value of n? That is minus 26. It's a simple calculation. You can also calculate. Okay, now what is the value of this determinant? B equal to 2 under root 3 multiplied by 3 under root 3 minus 9 into 2. Okay, so first of all, solve this. 2 into root 3 into 3 into root 3, that is 2 into 3, 6, and root 3 into root 3, that is root 9. And what is the value of root 9? Equal to 3. So 6 into 3, that is 18, minus 9 into 2, 18. So the value of this determinant is 0. Okay, so in this way we can calculate the values of determinant which is having degree 2. Okay, so this is about the lecture number 3. And in next lecture, we'll cover the next topic. So thanks for watching. Do like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much.